Welcome to Colorlight course. In this video, we will introduce you how to configure the mapping. Firstly, what is a LED screen mapping file? It is a file used to configure the processor to correctly recognize the sequence of the receiving card's installation. Secondly, why do we need to configure the mapping? If the processor cannot match the installation order of the receiving card, the LED screen may show disordered images or fail to display the corresponding signal images. To solve this problem, we will now explain how to set the mapping. First, double-click the LED setting software, select Screen Configuration, and enter the password 168 or 777, then click on Receiver Mapping at the top. Before operating, we need to know the screen's installation information. Take this screen as an example. Its resolution is 1920 by 960 and is controlled by an X4S processor. This processor controls 24 receiving cards, 6 in width and 4 in height. Each receiving card controls 320 by 240 pixels. First, set the number of receiving cards. Enter the numbers 6 and 4 in the receiver's count, and then you will see 24 rectangles appear on the software. They represent the 24 receiving cards. Second, select all receiving cards and change their resolution to 320 pixels wide and 240 pixels high. If some receiving cards need to have different resolutions, you can only select a portion of them to modify the resolution. Next, according to the connection order of the receiving card from the front view of the screen, set the mapping for each port of the processor. Click on port 1, and then click or drag the mouse to draw the receiving cards into corresponding order. After completing the connection for port 1, you can see the capacity ratio of this port on the left side. If the total pixels exceeds the port's limitation, it will turn red to alert you. Additionally, you can use the quick mapping buttons to quickly complete the settings. Please note, first, the mapping direction need to be based on the screen's front view. Second, the maximum load capacity of a single port on the processor is 655,360 pixels. However, it is not the simple sum of all the receiving card's pixels, but the whole area of the largest rectangle formed by the control area of all the receiving cards on this port. Similarly, you can complete the settings for other Ethernet ports. Finally, click Send to check if the display is normal. Click Save to Devices to prevent parameter loss after power off. Up to this step, we have completed the mapping settings in standard mode. And that's a wrap on the configuration of the mapping. See you next time.